This Torah class is brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.
Today we'll speak on the last halacha of Hanukkah. What do we do with the leftovers from the oil, the leftovers of the weeks of the Hanukkah candles? There is a Tosafot, Masechet Shabbat, Daf Mem Dalet. Tosafot says over there, they bring a baraita. Motar Hashemen, שבלילה הראשון, מוסיף עליו, מדליק בלילה השני. בלילה השמיני, עושה לו מדורה ושורפו בפני עצמו. If you have leftovers from the candles on the first night, you use it for the second night. You have leftovers from the second night, you use it on the third night. You have leftovers from the oil on the last day of Hanukkah, what do? You take this oil, you take those wicks, and you make a small medura, you make a fire, and you burn everything. You don't keep it. Why? Says Tosafot, since this oil was specified for the mitzvah of Hanukkah, we cannot use it for other purposes. We cannot use it even for other mitzvot. Similar to what we have on Chag Sukkot, if a person puts decorations on a sukkah, the sukkah itself and its decorations cannot be used during the sukkah times, during the sukkah days, during the hag. Why? It's mukzeh lemitzvato, hukzeh lemitzvato. Also, this oil of Hanukkah, hukzeh for the mitzvah, it's mukzeh for the mitzvah. And there is a difference between the aitzim of sukkah, or the decorations of the sukkah, and the oil of Hanukkah. The woods, or the decorations, meant to last. So, from the beginning, you're specifying it for the mitzvah, for the days of the Hag. You know it's going to last after the Hag. The Hag is going to be over, but the woods of the Sukkah, the decorations of the Sukkah, I'm going to be able to use. So therefore, the Muktzeh that you do, it's only for the days of the Hag. Once the Hag is over, you're allowed to benefit from the leftovers. But here, you put oil in the candles. Do you expect this oil to last? Usually a person puts oil in the candles and he wants it to be burned. He means to use it for the mitzvah. So therefore, this oil is considered mukzeh le mitzvato, and it's asur be'ana'ah. We cannot use it for other purposes. We cannot use it at all. And Chachamim was so strict about it, they didn't even wanted us to keep it for the next year, Hanukkah. Why? You're going to forget. It's a long time. It's a whole year. You're going to keep this oil aside. And maybe in the middle of the year, you're going to need the oil for something else. You take it. You forget it's meant for Hanukkah. So therefore, the halacha says you have to burn it. That's the opinion of the Tosafot over there. Aran, in the beginning of Bamei Madlikin, Mefaresh, Shitat Harif, that he disagreed with this opinion. It says over there that once the candles pass the half hour, you can shut it off yourself. Or you can benefit from it. If you want to use the oil for other things, for other needs, or if you want to use the candles even while it's still on, you want to use the candles for other purposes, you're allowed to. The strict halakha not to use the candles, and the nerot halalu kodesh hem, it's only the half hour of the mitzvah. But more than that, if the candles were on for longer than the half an hour, you can use it. Not only that, you can shut it off and take the oil for other needs. That's what the Rif says. Says Haran, looks from the Rif, he disagrees with this Tosafot. Miktzat ha-geonim, Rif didn't have Tosafot. Tosafot were after the Rif. Rif were before the Tosafot. But the opinion that the Tosafot is bringing, Tosafot brings a baraita, Tanya. Mordechai says it's Psikta Rabbati, Parashat Naso. Psikta Rabbati, it's like Divrei Tanaim. But in our sources, we have it in Sefer She'eltot. Sefer She'eltot, She'eltot Rav Achai Gaon, Shema Kaf Zayin, he says this halacha, that you cannot use the oil for other purposes. You have to burn the oil. Whatever you have leftovers from Hanukkah, you have to burn. Says Haran, Arif disagree with this halakha. The Arif tells you, you are allowed to shut off the candles. And also, Arif says, kavta en zakukla, that's the halakha brings, mentioned in the Gemara. What does it mean, kavta en zakukla? You don't have to relight it. Why? The mitzvah is over. Says Haran, Harif's opinion, that you can use the oil even for this half an hour. Even if the candles were shut off in the middle of the half an hour. Let's say you put the candles, they were on for 1 minute. You put enough oil for a whole half hour. They were on only for 1 minute. Since they were shut off by itself, kavta en zakukla, now the leftovers, it's considered reshut, hulin. It's not kadosh. Why? Ran explains Shittat Arif. The Arif holds the mitzvah, it's as long the candles are on. That's the mitzvah. Once the candles been turned off, the mitzvah is over. It's like after Sukkot already. If we're comparing the candles of Hanukkah to Sukkot, the mitzvah of Hanukkah, it's as long the candles are on. That's all. After the candles were shut off, the mitzvah is over. While the candles are on, I cannot use not the candles, not the light, and not the oil for other purposes specified for the mitzvah. But after the candles were shut off, everything becomes reshut, everything becomes hurin. The mitzvah is over, the holiday is over for this particular oil, and therefore, it's permissible. You can use it for anything you want. This is the opinion of Harif, and this is the opinion of Harambam. Harambam brings the Rif that after half an hour, you can shut off the candles. Or you can use it. So we have two opinions now. Shittat HaShe'eltot, Mekzat HaGeonim, and Tosafot, Masechet Shabbat, Daf Mem Daled. You cannot use the oil from leftovers of Hanukkah, you have to burn it. Harif and Harambam holds, you can use the oil no matter from which part of the oil you have. If it's the first half hour, or even longer than that, kavahome longer than that, you can use it. That's the opinion of Harambam and Harif. Also Haramban, Veharan, they agree with them. We have a third shita over here. Shitat HaRosh and Shitat HaTur. Rosh, on one hand, it brings the halakha that after half an hour, you can use it. After half an hour, you can shut off the candles, you can use the oil. But the Rosh, at the same time, brings the halakha, if you have leftovers from the oil, you have to burn it. So the Ahwanim are asking, it's a contradiction. If you can shut it off, you can use the oil. Why the Rosh tells me, if I have leftovers, I have to burn it? You just told me I can use it. So therefore, they're explaining Harosh's opinion, there is a difference when you have this oil, where the oil from. If it's from the first half hour, or if it's more than that. If the candles were shut off from the first half hour, that's the ikar of the mitzvah, the first half hour. So if you have leftovers from the oil there, the candles were less than half an hour on. Then they were shut off. This oil is mukzele mitzvah. This oil you have to burn. This oil you cannot use. But if the candles were on, they last more than half an hour. And then you have leftovers from the oil. This oil is permissible. It's mutar. The difference is if it's from the ikar of the mitzvah, this oil is from the hatzi sha'a of the mitzvah, or if it's more than the hatzi sha'a. If it's from the hatzi sha'a itself, then it's mukzele mitzvato and it's asur. And if it's more than the hatzi sha'a, then it's reshut and it's mutar. This opinion has been according to Halakha and Shulchan Aruch. Maran followed this opinion. Same as they explain in the Rosh, we have Shitat HaRi'az, Rabbeinu Yeshaya Aharon. Also, Agot Maimoniot, Perek Dalet Ma'alachot Hanukkah, brings the same pshara in behalf of Maharam. It depends where this oil comes from. If it comes from the half an hour, then it's Asur. It's considered Mukzele Mitzvato. If it came from more than half an hour, it's Rashut, it's Hulin, it's Mutar. That's the opinion of Maran Beit Yosef. Maran is passing this halakha, Shulchan Aruch Siman Tav Resh Ayin Zayin. But Maran is bringing another addition to this halakha. If this oil that it's asur from the first half hour, got mixed with other oil. Let's say you go home now, after if you hear the show, you're asking your wife, what did you do with the oil we have left from last night? She tells you, I put it back in the bottle. There's so much oil. What am I going to do with this? Haval, bal tashhit. I put it back in the bottle. Now you have mixed of oil which is asur and oil which was muta. Leftovers, we're not talking about the bottle. Whatever was in the bottle, it's hulin. What you have in the candles from the first half hour, that's the oil which is muktzeh mitzvah. That's the oil that it's asur. We were supposed to burn it, but she didn't know. She put it back in the bottle. What's the halakha now? You know the rule is, any isur which got mixed with heter, you need 60. You need 60 times more than the heter, more than the isur. So says Shulchan Aruch, im yesh 60 b'shemen amutar, az batel. If you have 60, you have 60 times on the oil which is mutar, more than the oil which is asur, everything is mutar. But if you don't have 60, yesh umrim she'asur le'arbot alav u'levatelo. You want to add, you don't have 60. Let's say you measure, the bottle wasn't so big. From the oil that you have leftovers, maybe you have, let's say, 20 grams of oil. If you have 20 grams of oil, you need 1,200 grams of kosher oil to cancel it. But you don't have that much. It's a small bottle, less than a liter. What are you going to do now? Are we allowed to add more? Can I take some more kosher oil to mix with the mixture I have over here? So I will have 60 in the end. Now I don't have 60. I'll make it 60. Can I do that? Can I add more oil to cancel it? Says Shulchan Aruch, Yesh Omrim she'asur le'arbot alav. Who's this Yesh Omrim? This Yesh Omrim is Shitat Maharam Merotenburg. Maharam Merotenburg says, you cannot add more to cancel. What's the source of this halakha? The source of this halakha is a Gemara, Masechet Betza, Daf Dalet Amud Bet. Gemara says over there, עצים שנשרו מן הדקל לתוך התנור. On Yom Tov, you want to cook, or you want to bake, you want to make a barbecue. On Yom Tov, you're allowed to. But what happened? You have a tree right above the barbecue, and sticks, branches from the tree fell straight into the oven, straight into the barbecue. Those woods that fell from the tree, the branches that fell from the tree, they are called mukzeh. The halacha is, I cannot use them. Why? At the beginning of Shabbat, in the beginning of Yom Tov, they were mechubar. They were connected to the tree. Can I go cut branches from the tree on Yom Tov? Although I'm allowed to cook on Yom Tov, I can make a barbecue on Yom Tov. Cannot cut the tree to make the barbecue. On Yom Tov, the menachot that I'm allowed to do, it's from melechet lisha va'elach. From doing, on the process of making the bread, from doing and on, I can do on Yom Tov. Cutting the woods, it's kotzer. It's from before Lisha. This melacha is not permissible on Yom Tov. So since it was mukzeh, it was mechubar, and I'm not allowed to cut the atzim on Yom Tov, it becomes mukzeh. If it's mukzeh, I cannot use it. But I want to make a barbecue, says the halacha over there, Amar Rav Matna, marbe alehem atzim mutarim umevatelan. Take more woods. I have other woods which is prepared for the barbecue. I'll add on the forbidden sticks, on the forbidden branches, I'll put the kosher woods on the top of them, cancel everything, and now I can make a barbecue. Gemara is asking, how do you do that? You cannot cancel the isur. Says the Gemara, what we're not allowed to cancel isur, it's if isur deoraita. Isur deoraita, let's say hazir. Hazir fell into your food. And you don't have 60. Hazir, it's Isur Deoraita. And Mevatelin, Isur Lechatechila. Isur Deoraita, and Mevatelin. But here, it's Isur Mukteh. The Aitzim, the woods that fell into the barbecue, they are Mukteh. Mukteh, it's Isur Derabbanan. Bede Rabbanan, Mevatelin. Gemara is continuing to ask. Ole Rav Ashi de'amar. Bedavar sheyesh lo matirin. Afilu bede Rabbanan, Mevatelin. Afilu be'elef labatin. Ma yikale mema? Says the Gemara, Shane Achad and Mikla Kale Isura. Rav Ashi says, the Davar Sheish Lo Matirin, even if you have thousands against that, it's not batil. And even if it's the Rabbanan, it's not batil. Here, we're talking about mukzeh. The issur of mukzeh, it's davar sheyesh lo matirin. What does it mean, davar sheyesh lo matirin? Now it's asur. Al mutzei yom tov, it's going to be mutar. It's similar to perot anoshrin. Fruits, if you have a tree of fruits in your backyard, and a fruit came fell down from the tree on Shabbat, can I use this apple on Shabbat? I want to say beracha. 100 berachot, I have to have 100 berachot on Shabbat. I want to take this apple and say borei peri ha'aretz on Shabbat. Am I allowed to? Cannot do that. Why? This apple is mukzeh. It was connected to the tree on the beginning of Shabbat. Migod yitkatzah lebein ha'shmashot, yitkatzah lekulei yomah. Once it was mukzeh on the beginning of Shabbat, it stays mukzeh for the whole Shabbat. So I cannot take this apple. Although now it fell from the tree. It's not connected, but it's mukzeh. Let's say the child took the apple and put it in the box of apples you have inside the house. Those apples you have from before Shabbat, all of them were permitted. They were good apples. But now he mixed the mukzeh apple with the other apples. What's the halakha now? Can I take one of the apples? Can I do batol b'shishim? Take, it's more than 60. There's 600 apples in the box. Can I cancel these two? Cannot. Why? It's davar sheyesh lo matirin. Now it's asur. On Motzei Shabbat it's going to be mutar. Why cancel? Wait a few hours and everything will be permitted. Why you need to do bitulim? That's called davar sheyesh lo matirin. Although it's asur de rabbanan. Mukzeh is de rabbanan. It's asur de rabbanan. And it's batel. It's more than 60. Afilu be'elef. Lo batel. Cannot cancel it. Until Shabbat is going to be over, then it's going to be mutar. So over here, it's the same inyan. The etzim ha-mukzeh. Gemara says, marbi aleim etzim vatilan. How do you do that? It's davar sheyesh lo matirin. Gemara answers like this. Hacha mikla kale isura. What does it mean, mikla kale? The woods, when are you benefiting from the sticks, from the branches, after they were burned? If you make a barbecue, you know, you can't make a fire and put the meat straight in the fire. What's going to happen? Before it gets cooked, it's going to be burned. You have to wait till the woods are going to be burnt completely. The wood is going to turn into charcoals, into coals. And after it, the fire is down. Now you put the meat on top. That's how you make a barbecue. Right? Huh? I heard you're a professional. You know how to make a good barbecue? That's how you do it. You wait till the fire is off, and then you put the meat on top. You can just put them the meat directly when the fire is a big fire. That's called Nikla Kale Isura. What does it mean? The Isur is been burnt already. And therefore, it's mutar. That's the Gemara. This Mahloket Rishonim, how do we passing on this Gemara? It's the second terutz of the Gemara, Mikla Kale Isura, answers the first question also. What was the first question? Ebivatilin Isur Chatehila. We cannot cancel the Isur. Now Gemara is answering, Mikla Kale Isura, and if the Isur is being burnt, then you can cancel the Isur. If I'll take this answer as a terutz also for the first question, so now there's no difference between Isur de Rabbanan or Isur de Oraita. The difference would be the Isur is burnt or the Isur still exists. If the Isur is burnt, you can cancel it. If the Isur is not burnt, you can't cancel it, even if it's Isur de Rabbanan. That's the opinion of Maharam Rotenburg. Maharam Rotenburg says the last answer of the Gemara answers not on the second answer or question also, only, but also on the first question. Mevatelin isur. When I do not mevatel the isur, if the isur ba'ayin, but if the isur is burnt, I can mevatel the isur. That's how Maharam is learning the Gemara. And therefore, says Maharam, if you have oil, leftovers from Hanukkah, this oil was mixed with another oil, with kosher oil, and you don't have shishim, you cannot add more to make it shishim. Why? You cannot be mevatel the isur. When you're allowed to be mevatel, if the isur is burnt, like the aitzim that fell into the oven, then the aitzim being burnt, you can be mevatel. But before it's burnt, you cannot mevatel, even if it's isur, the rabbanan. That's the source of this halacha. But Harambam, Perek Tetva, Malachot Va'achalot Asurot, Halacha Kafzayin, הרמב״ם says over there, אין מבטלין איסור לך תחילה, אני מילא באיסור תורה. אבל באיסור דה רבנן מבטלין. רמב״ם is passing like the first תירוץ in the Gemara. Only בדבר שיש לו מתירין, I need מקלה קלה איסורה. But if it's not דבר שיש לו מתירין, the first תירוץ of the Gemara, that the Gemara is making the חילוק between the right and the רבנן, stays להלכה. And the Rambam is bringing two examples. כיצד? בשר בחלב. בשר בחלב, you know, when is בשר בחלב אסור מן התורה? Only if you have בשר בהמה תאורה, בחלב בהמה תאורה. התורה says, לא תבשה גדי בחלב אמו. גדי, it's a kosher animal. Kosher domestic animal. גדי, it's an example. גדי, and the פרה, and the כבש, yeah, if it's a lamb, or if it's a veal, or if it's a cow, or if it's beef, kosher animals, domestic animals. And halev imo, it's mother's milk, which means also the halav is from behema teora. Basar behema teora, behalav behema teora, that is the sur Torah. So Rambam says like this. Let's say you're cooking a stew of meat, beef meat, you're cooking in a pot. And then somebody passes by with a cup of milk, and it bang into something, and the whole cup fills into the beef, and get mixed with together with this. What's the halacha? Basar b'halav. It's isur deoraita. You need to have 60, right? 1 to 60. If you have in the meat 60 times more than the halav, then it's going to be mutar. How do you measure it? You measure it with everything you had in the pot. If it was soup, so the soup, the vegetables, the beef, the spices, everything together. I have 60. If I have 60 times more than the, let's say, one cup of milk fell into the pot. I have 60 cups of meat and soup. On the other hand, that's going to cancel the halav, and everything is going to be mutar. If I don't have 60, I have 59. Against this cup of milk, I have 59 of cups of soup. What's the halakha then? It's all asur. Everything is asur. Basar b'halav, it's asur not only b'achila, asur b'ana'a also. Three times the Torah says, לא תבשר גדי בחלב אמו. אחד איסור אכילה, אחד איסור הנאה, אחד איסור בישול. You cannot cook basar b'halav, you cannot eat basar b'halav, and you cannot benefit from basar b'halav. Let's say you have a dog, you want to give it to the dog. You can't give it to the dog. You want to give it to your neighbor, he's a goy, you want to give it to him. You can't give it to him. You want to sell it to a goy, you can't sell it. Why? Asur b'ana'a. So now I have 59 times against this cup of milk. I don't have 60. Can I add another cup, make it 60? No. Why? It's asur d'oraita. Hazir and milk, it's not asur d'oraita. Yeah. Rambam brings another example. Let's say make it chicken soup. עוף בחלב, it's the רבנן. מן התורה, בתורה says, לא תבשה גדי בחלב אמו. Only if it's בהמה תאורה, then it's אסור מן התורה. But עוף בחלב, it's גזרה דה רבנן. חכמים decree not to eat chicken with milk. Why? People call it meat. People call the chicken also meat. If you're going to permit them to mix the meat with the chicken with the milk, so the next day they're going to mistake and they're going to mix also beef with milk. So Chachamim said, do not eat chicken with meat. It's Isur de Rabbanan. So now, what happened? You're cooking a chicken soup, and by mistake, this cup of milk fell into the soup. And you measure, you don't have 60. You have 30 times, you have 20 times against the cup of milk. It's a small pot. Are you allowed to add more to make it 60? Says the Rambam, yes, you're allowed to. Why? Basar off behalav, it's the Rabbanan. The Gemara said, when I'm not allowed to be mevatel the Isura Nemile, the Oraita. Ava be the Rabbanan, mevatelin. Mevatelin, it doesn't mean that I can take the cup of milk and purposely put it in the chicken soup and say, oh, it's the Rabbanan, I can cancel it. If a person does it purposely, it all becomes asur. Kansur to hachamim, afilu be'elef lo batil. We're talking about b'shogeg. It happened by mistake. Yeah? The cup of milk spilled into the soup, the chicken soup, by mistake. I don't have shishim. It's already ta'arovet. is not me'arev lechatchila, literally takes the milk and mix it with the meat. It got mixed already, but I don't have shishim. So here comes the halacha and tells me I can add more into the soup, more water, more vegetables, even more chicken. Anything I can, anything I have, I put more in the soup, I make it shishim, more than the halav, and everything is going to be mutam. This is a Rambam's opinion. There's a third opinion that's mechalek tosafot masechet betza between isur de rabbanan sheyesh lo aikar min haTorah and isur de rabbanan sheyesh lo aikar min haTorah. What is it? The rabbanan sheyesh lo aikar min haTorah. Let's say, for an example, dam shebishelo. You know, when you kashering the meat, and the process of kashering with the meat, we are soaking the meat in water, and then we're salting the meat. Why we do that? Because the Torah says, "Rak hazak meod levilti echol adam, ki adam wa nafesh." The Torah says you have to be very careful not to eat the blood. So what do? Before we cook in the meat, we soak in the meat in water. We let it be soaked in water for an hour, and afterwards we are taking salt, thick salt. We're salting the meat. The nature of the salt is to suck the blood out of the meat. And then, after we did that, we're washing it, shaking the salt out of the meat, washing it properly, and then we can cook the meat. Before we did that, the blood which is in the meat, it's asur. It's called dama evarim, sheperash. It's isur deoraita. There's three levels in isur dam. Dam she'anefesh teruya bo, this blood that comes out during the shechita, if a person eats this dam, hayav karet. Dam ha'evarim, which means it's not from the shechita, it's after shechita, what comes out from the evarim, from the organs, that's called dam ha'evarim she'pirash, came out from the ever, it's isur lav, hav malkot. Dam ha'evarim she'lo pirash, if it didn't come out, that's mutar. Dam ha'evarim shelo pirash lo asur. Why before cooking I need to salt the meat and to take out the blood? Because during the cooking process, the blood will come out. The broil of the food will cause the blood to come out. So therefore, I need to make sure no blood is going to come out. Torah says, take the blood before you cook. How do I do that? By soaking, salting, kashering it. What if a person forgot? He took this piece of meat. Nowadays, we're buying everything from the grocery. And everything is already after kashered. It's kashered, it was soaked and salted, and the blood was taken out. But sometimes people do private shechita. They take a ship, they do shechita. Huh? You heard about situations like this? You heard about it. So what do? You need to know how to kasher the meat. When you do shechita like this, you have to be careful. So many issues can appear. It's not just to take out the blood. That's the easiest part. There is also Yisur Halev. Yisur Halev, it's also Yisur Deoraita. You got to have a professional, a Tamid Chacham, who's going to be able to tell you where is the Halev located in the animal which is forbidden. It's Yisur Karet. Halev is Yisur Karet. There are many places in the animal which has Halev. On the kidneys, on the stomach, Halev Sha'ala Kisalim, Sha'ala Kerev, Sha'ala Muntna, Sha'ala Kedayot. There's a few places in the animal there is Halev. You got to have someone who knows the halakha and also knows the anatomy of the animal. And he knows not just theoretically the halakha, but also practical. He has the experience to tell you this is halev and this is asur. He knows how to remove it. Not only halev, there is asur gidanashe. Gidanashe is the easiest part. It's a small piece. Bashor agas arba, it's about 8 centimeters on the big ox. And the shape is small. But there is shumano shel gid. Shumano shel gid, Yisrael kedoshim, na'agu bo isur. And the fat of the gid and ashe goes all the way till the hooves of the animal. And it's split. On one side splits to two, from two to three, and the other side to three, from three to two. It's complicated. You got to have someone who knows how to follow it, how to take it out. If not, shumano shel gid, Yisur de Rabbanan, Yisrael kedoshim, na'agu bo isur. But the isur of Halev, it's Yisur Deoraita. Gidan Hashem itself is Deoraita. There are also Kele Dam that needs to be cut and removed. If you don't cut them, it's not enough to salt. They are like very thick blood vessels. They almost like a dish. They're holding the blood. The salt is not enough to take it out. You need to cut them to let the blood go out. So when you do private shechita like this, you got to have someone who knows the halachot, all these details, is going to be able to walk you through the process of kashering the meat, and then you'll be able to eat it. Otherwise, chas v'shalom, people make so many mistakes. The shohet has to be a professional shohet. And they have to do the shechita in a proper place. There are certain places they do shechita over there, and maybe the shechita was good, but then they take the chicken, they put it in hot water before it was salted, before it was kashered. There's many issues regarding that. Yisur dam, yisur helev, and if it's the animals. So you gotta make sure you go to shohet yirei shamayim. And the place where you do the shechita is also a good place. They're not using hot water on the meat before it's kashered. And then you gotta have a Talmid Chacham who's gonna tell you what's helev, what's gid anashe, what's kiledam. And after everything's been taken care of properly, then you can eat it. So, isur dam, this blood, if someone made a mistake and took a piece from the meat and he cooked it in the pot. Now the blood which comes out of this meat, what's the halakha of this blood? We said before, dam ha'evarim sheperash, asur min ha'torah. But that is only if it perash before cooking. If it's perash and cooked, the blood got cooked together with the food, dam shebishelo asur midrabbanan. The isur of dam mevushal, it's not isur deoraita, isur derabbanan. Now, I have cooked food. I have a lot of meat. All the other meat was kosher. Just one piece was not kosher. So one piece of meat was with the blood. But I have a huge pot over there with other pieces of meat and vegetables and soup that was kosher. I don't have shishim. I need 60 times in the food more than this hatikha, this piece of meat which wasn't kashered. I need 60 times more than that. I don't have shishim. Can I add shishim now to make it kasher? Sister Safot, here I cannot do that. Why? This is isur dam, although it's isur de rabbanan, but it's the rabbanan sheyesh lo ikar min haTorah. Because the isur dam generally in the Torah is isur deoraita. So that's called isur de rabbanan sheyesh lo ikar min haTorah. The rabbanan sheyesh lo ikar min haTorah hem vatilin isur lechatechila. What kind of isur the rabbanan I can cancel? Like mukze. Mukze, it's isur de rabbanan sheyesh lo ikar min haTorah. But the rabbanan, אפשר לבטל. Or bishule goyim. I have a piece of meat that the goy cooked. It's kosher meat. The goy cooked it. What's the isur on this piece of meat? So the rabbanan. If this key meat got mixed with the rest, I can add more. I can add more, make it shishim. If we mix with cooking together, I can make shishim against it. Huh? Shatnez isur deoraita. Shatnez deoraita. Also shatnez, it be too b'shatnez. If it's one string of wool mixed into linen or the opposite, even be'elef labatil. Chut echad oseret kol ha'begel. There is no bitul. On sha'atnez, there is no bitul. There are certain isurim, they have no bitul, even 1/1000. Sha'atnez is one of them. Can't be mevatel the isur of tzemer be'pishtan or pishtan be'tzemer, even chut echad oseret kol ha'begel. A huge begel. One chut, one string. The whole begad is asur. There is no bitul on sha'atnez. Also, hadash. Isur hadash. Kema hadash, lo batel. Afilu be'elef lo batel. Why? Davar shesh lo matirin. It's isur deoraita, of course isur deoraita. It's davar shesh lo matirin. Now it's asur. When Pesach is going to come, the 16th or Chutz La'aretz 17th of Nisan, everything is going to be muta. So this kemah, it's considered davar sheyesh lo matirin. Davar sheyesh lo matirin, afilu b'de rabbanan. Afilu b'elef, lo batel. Here it's not de rabbanan. Isur hadash is isur deoraita, according to Shulchan Aruch. Maran Shulchan Aruch is paskin hadash asur min haTorah. Even b'chutz la'aretz. Even was growing by a goy's field. It's asur min haTorah. Now it's the times when you need to be careful about hadash. Now many new flowers coming into the market. We just caught recently one of the stores, one of the bakeries. Rabbi Malkiel went inside to inspect the place, and he found packages of kemah, which was kemah hadash, not safek yashan, safek hadash. He checked the codes of the manufacturer. This kemah was ground, this wheat was ground a few weeks ago. The kemah is completely hadash. The tefuah growth after Pesach. Not safek hadash. Hadash gamur. 100% hadash. Isur deoraita worse than hazir. Hazir batel b'shishim. Isur hadash is not batel b'shishim. Now it's the time to be careful about this. Baruch Hashem, he caught it on time. They removed it from the place. The owner of the place, the bakery, made a mistake. He didn't realize. We saved him and we saved the whole community from a big, big, has shalom, michshol, big isur. Baruch Hashem, ishtabach shum al-ad, there is a tremendous siyata dishmaya. Coming back to our topic. If the isur, says Tosafot, it's isur de Rabbanan, שיש לו עיקר מן התורה, הם לבטלים. You cannot add to make it 60. But if it's סוד הרבנן, שאין לו עיקר מן התורה, like בשולי גויים, מוקצה, it's the רבנן שאין לו עיקר מן התורה. עוף בחלב, what is it? בשר עוף בחלב, דבר שיש לו עיקר מן התורה. Although עוף בחלב itself is the רבנן, but the איסור of בשר בחלב, the main isur, it's isur de oraita. So that's considered isur de rabbanan, sheyesh lo aikar min haTorah. According to Tosafot, I cannot add more to cancel the isur. So I have three opinions now. Maharam Rotenburg is the most mahmir opinion. What does he say? Even isur de rabbanan I cannot add to cancel. When I'm allowed to add, only if the isur is being burnt, miklakalei isura, then I can add. That's the most strict opinion, the opinion of Maharam Rotenburg. The middle opinion is the opinion of Tosafot. They say there is a difference between isur de rabbanan and isur de rabbanan sheyesh lo ikar min haTorah. And of course, isur de oraita. So isur de oraita, em mevatilin. It's according to all of the opinions. Isur de oraita, em mevatilin. But the rabbanan, what kind of the rabbanan can be mevatel? I can be mevatel only the Rabbanan, which doesn't have a ikar min haTorah. And the most lenient opinion is the opinion of Rambam. Rambam says the difference is only between the Oraita and the Rabbanan. But among Isurim the Rabbanan, I don't make a difference between yesh lo ikar min haTorah or ein lo ikar min haTorah. All of them, I can add more to make it shishim to be mevatel the Isur. Therefore, the example the Rambam is bringing me, what's the example the Rambam is using? Of b'halav. Which is the Rabbanan שיש לו עקר מן התורה, and even though it's יש לו עקר מן התורה, I can add, I can make it 60 to cancel the איסור. What's the הלכה? יין נסך, it's depends, if it's a חשש יין נסך ממש, ספק, זה רבנן, יש לו איסור דאורייתא. זה איסור דאורייתא. אז סתם יינה מסדר רבנן. השולחן ערוך, ביורה דעה, סימן צדיק ט', סעיף ו', מרן over there brings Rambam is opinion. Maran is pasken halacha like Harambam. Maran says, "Ein mevatelin isur lechatechila." Ani mile beisur deoraita, aval beisur de rabbanan mevatelin. If the isur de rabbanan, I can add, I can make it shishim, I can be mevatel the isur, and that's going to be mutar. And Maran is bringing the examples of Harambam. If it's basar behalav. If it's basar behema teora, behalav behema teora, which is isur Torah, em mevatelin. Aber basar of behalav, mevatelin. Why? Maran holds. There's no difference between the Rabbanan sheyesh lo ikar min haTorah, ein lo ikar min haTorah. If it's isur de Rabbanan, I can add and make 60 out of the mixture, 60 in the heter more than the isur, and that's going to be all permitted. This is Shulchan Aruch, Yoreh Dea. Now I have a contradiction in Shulchan Aruch. Why? Here in Halachot Hanukkah, Siman Tafresh Ayin Zayin, Maran is quoting Maharam Rotenburg, that says, if you have leftovers from the Hanukkah candles, and you mixed it by mistake with kosher oil. You put the oil back in the bottle. And now you have a mixture of kosher oil and not kosher oil, which means mukzeh le-mitzvah and hulin. Says Maran, and marbin alav. Im en shishim, if you don't have shishim, you cannot add and make it shishim. Why? Why you cannot marbe? The isur of mukzeh. It's isur de rabbanan or isur de oraita? What's the isur over here? So the rabbanan. When you already ask Shulchan Aruch is paskin, if it's the rabbanan, mevatelin. That's a contradiction in Shulchan Aruch. Understand the kushiyah? Kushiyah from halachot Hanukkah to halachot Arovot. Here in halachot Hanukkah, Maran says, if you don't have shishim more than the oil, you cannot be marbe to make it shishim. Although it's isur de rabbanan. And over there, in Yoreh Deah, Siman Tzadik Tet, Maran says, if it's isur de rabbanan, I can marbe, I can make it shishim, and cancel the isur. All the achronim are asking this contradiction in Shulchan Aruch. Hashach, Yoreh Deah over there, Magen Avraham over here, Peri Hadash, Peri Toa, all the achronim are asking these questions. A couple of answers the achronim are giving, but all the answers are terutzim d'chukim. Shach himself, he brings a terutz. He says, there is a different isur mukzeh le-mitzvah. It's more hamur than a regular isur. Mukzeh le-mitzvato. But Shach himself says, v'dohak. This terutz, the kushiyah is better than terutz. I have a contradiction here. Isur de rabbanan. After all, this mukzeh le-mitzvah, it's isur de rabbanan. Mukzeh le-mitzvah, but it's rabbanan. The rabbanan should be mutar, should be allowed to add, to make it shishim. There is an opinion among the poskim that says the candle of Hanukkah has a power of the oraita. Although the main mitzvah of Ner Hanukkah is the Rabbanan, but Ner Hanukkah has something special about it. Since the takana of Chachamim was to light this candle, Zecher l'menorah b'vet ha-mikdash. It's not just a regular mitzvah. It comes to remember the miracles that happened in the menorah b'vet ha-mikdash. So Chachamim gave it a power, gave it a level of the oraita. We see that in the halakha that says we cannot use the candles. Nerot talalu kodesh ve'en anu reshut nishtamesh bahem. Rishonim are asking, tashmish shel mitzvah, can I do? I want to learn Torah next to the Hanukkah candles. Am I allowed to learn Torah? The Hanukkah candles is compared to the menorah in Beit HaMikdash. The menorah in Beit HaMikdash brings wisdom. הרוצה להחכים, ידרים, שמנורה בדרום. If you have a חוכמה, you lean in tefillah towards south. Why? Menorah stands in south, on the south side of Beit HaMikdash. But the menorah brings wisdom. I want to learn Torah next to the menorah candles. Next to Hanukkah, why not? Kodesh. If it's Kodesh, cannot use it. It's not really Kadosh. Really Kadosh, Gemara says, V'chiner Kedusha yesh bo. There's no real Kedusha, it's not Kadosh. But we're comparing it like to the menorah in Beit HaMikdash. Hachamim gave it a power of Kedusha, the same as the menorah of Beit HaMikdash. It's not literally the same. That's a menorah that you lit at home. But Hachamim gave it strictness, like if it's the menorah in Beit HaMikdash. You see a similar inyan to this, Ramban, בפירושו לתורה פרשת בעלותיך, Ramban brings the midrash, the famous midrash, לעלות נר תמיד, we just read about חנוכת המזבח. All the leaders of the tribe served special קורבנות on the חנוכת המזבח. אהרון הכהן was supposed to be the leader of שבט לוי, and he did not serve any קורבן during חנוכת המזבח. חלשה דעתו של אהרון הכהן. אמר לה הקדוש ברוך הוא שלך גדולה משלהם. Yours is greater than theirs. What's greater? You have the menorah. בעלותיך את המנורה. בעלותיך את הנרות, למול פני המנורה, יראו שבעת הנרות. מה, what's greater? What's greater than the menorah more than the קורבנות? תורה says, נר תמיד. The menorah is going to last forever. Where? Menorah lasts forever. After the destruction of Beit HaMikdash was destroyed, Mizbeach was destroyed, and the menorah was taken away. There's no menorah. Says Ramban, מכאן רמז לנר חנוכה מן התורה. Here we see a source for נר חנוכה. That's נר תמיד. נר תמיד, you want to know where is נר תמיד? מנורה אף חנוכה. which is compared to the menorah and Beit HaMikdash. So we have here source for Hanukkah candles in the Torah. It's like the Oraita. It's not the Oraita mamash, it's like the Oraita. It has the power of the Oraita. Similar to this, we have Ra'avad. Ra'avad, ב'הלכות ברכות, בהשגותיו על הרמב״ם, פרק י' א', over there, says Ra'avad, that the ברכה of ברכת להדליק נר חנוכה, the reason why we don't say על נר חנוכה, we say להדליק נר חנוכה, לפי שהמנורה, נרות חנוכה, זכר למקדש, עשו אותם כשל תורה, כשל המקדש. החכמים made this menorah like this is the Oraita. But it's not helping me to resolve this issue because after all, everybody admits it's not ממש the Oraita. הרב says, כשל תורה, כשל תורה, רמז מן התורה, כמו של תורה, כמו, כמו, it's the Rabbanan. After all, the Hanukkah candle is the Rabbanan. Who made it takana to light Hanukkah candles? בית דין של חשמונאים. That was the Rabbanan. It's not the Oraita. So if it's Yisur the Rabbanan, why can't it be add more than 60? Therefore, many Ahronim says, when I have a situation like this, a contradiction like this in Shulchan Aruch, I follow what Maran says, Sugiyah Beduchta. What is it, Sugiyah Beduchta? The main halachot of Ta'arovot, it's Shulchan Aruch Yoreh Di'ah Siman Tzadik Tet. Over there, that's the main Sugiyah of Ta'arovot. There is the topic of mixture of Isur and Heter, how we're dealing with this. Maran talks about all kinds of issues on those simanim over there. If it's בדבר שיש לו מתירים, if it's the חתיכה הרויה להתקבל, if it's the יבש ביבש, חד במיני, חד ביתרי בתיל, if it's לח בלח, all these עניינים of תערובות, the סוגיה of תערובות, is dealt in שולחן ערוך יורה דעה. Over there, the simanim of תערובות. But here in שולחן ערוך, אורח חיים, Maran doesn't talk about הלכות תערובות. That's not his topic. He's not dealing with תערובות. He's dealing with הלכות חנוכה. By the way, הטור בסימן תפרש עין זין, quoted the מהר"ם ברוטנבורג, Maran has mentioned his opinion. But if you want to know the הלכה, how do I hold if there is a mixture of איסור and היתר? Don't look over here. Go over there. סוגיה בדוכתה. That's the main place where I deal with the ערובות. You go there, you check the הלכה over there. And over there, the conclusion of שולחן ערוך, if it's איסור דה רבנן, you can add, you can be מבטל דה איסור. It's also משנה אחרונה. שולחן ערוך הרחיים was written first, and then שולחן ערוך יורה דעה. הלכה כמשנה אחרונה. So there's two reasons to say that Maran holds like what he wrote in יורה דעה, more than what he wrote over here in הלכות חנוכה. That's the opinion of הגאון פרי חדש, בחזקיה דה סילבה, over there in יורה דעה, is asking this contradiction in שולחן ערוך, and he says, the halakha for sure, Maran hold, like what he wrote over here, and you already are, that if he even in Hanukkah, you get mixed, you have the oil, got mixed with Hulin, you can make a shishim. You don't have shishim? Take another oil. Make a shishim. Make a shishim, and everything should be permitted. Why? Because this oil, it's Yisur Rabbanan. And with the Rabbanan, mevatelin Yisur Chatechila. הגאון רבי חיים בן עטר בספר פרי תואר says the same thing. And many other אחרונים follows this opinion. The conclusion of most of the אחרונים is that the oil that got mixed with other oil, it can be canceled. And if you remember in the beginning of the show, we mentioned that many poskim holds that even if you have before mixture, the leftovers from the menorah itself, many poskim holds that it's mutar. So now that it got mixed with other oil, I have a ספק ספיקה. שמי הלכה כדעת הריף, והרמב״ם, והרמב״ן, והר"ן, that all of them holds, הריטב"א also, they all holds that the leftovers of the oil is permitted. It's not אסור. And even if you will say, the הלכה is like the opinion of שאלתות, and the גאונים who says that the leftovers of the oil of the menorah is אסור, now that it got mixed, it's Yisur de Rabbanan, I can add more shishim, make it shishim, and then it's going to be permitted. So I have a safek sfeka. And the whole inyan, the whole mahloket over here, it's the amen of the Rabbanan. Sfeka de Rabbanan ikula. Even if it was an equal safek in Shulchan Aruch, what's the halakha? Like תפרש עין זין באור החיים, או צדיק תת ביורי דעה, אני רוצה ספק דרבנן לכולה. It's איסור דרבנן. כל שכן, over here, it's not a regular ספק. There is more base to say that the halakha is like what Maran said in Yorei Dea. And also I have many, many rishonim who says, from the beginning when it wasn't asur, this oil wasn't asur. The leftovers, it's mutar, according to many, many of the rishonim. And Arif and Rambam, שניים מתוך שלושה עמודי הוראה, they hold it's mutar. So therefore, there is a solid base over here to permit the leftovers from the Hanukkah candles if it got mixed with other oil. What do? You add more, you make it 60, and it's all going to be mutar. Baruch Adonai le'olam, amen ve'amen.
You've just experienced another Torah class brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.